My main work is working with the invisible. I work with what you can't see. And I've been doing it for 10 years. And I have been inspired by this. Anyway, I approach this through geometry, and you can do this process with anything, not just geometry. Geometry just happens to be what I was attracted to. Now, when you saw and heard Adriana, you should look at, if you didn't before or next time, look at her gestures, because all her gestures are lawful. All her gestures are based on my form. When she does those gestures, okay, I see the lawfulness in those gestures. And why can I see the lawfulness of gestures? Because I approach the word lawfully. So does she. She worked with the elements. She worked with earth, water, air, and fire. So do I. She worked with sulfur. She worked with salt. And she also works with mercury. So do I. This is a process that Rudolf Steiner worked with. Most of his work is based and used these elements. This is how he can come up with things that you just are amazed at. Why? Because they're lawful based on the way nature uses metamorphosis. We have to learn how to use metamorphosis all the time in our life, or we're going to be in trouble. And we're going to have heart problems. So, my work, I am not a doctor. I have no desire for that. I work with geometry. And luckily for me, I found a form that I believe is based on human heart. So now, for the first time, the heart can be looked at in a lawful geometric way, never before done. So that we can look at what I have here and find out, first off, if it's lawful, and second, does it make any sense, or is this a bunch of baloney? You have to be the judge of that. So you will see more of what the heart is saying through the geometry than ever before. No medical doctor or scientist has been able to find these things out. Why? Geometry wasn't here. It came in January 2000. Okay. So I was inspired by Rudolf Steiner when I went to the Earth Beyond, and I saw a model of this. And this is the real one that's burnt down, and there is a woman working up there on the carvings. And I love these capitals. So the Saturn capital is what inspired me, because it was such a beautiful form. And but there are seven of these, and they're reliefs. And I'm a sculptor. I'm interested in sculpture. I'm interested in the third dimension. This is basically two-dimensional. And the reason it is because I have the building. And I also was interested in the ceiling. I wondered, how do you do this? You know, where are these things coming from? What do they mean? And so forth and so on. Okay, that was kind of what started it. But they were all based on seven. There were seven points. There are seven of them. Now there are seven capitals. There are seven columns. There's seven, 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 seven everywhere. So I decided, well, I'm going to make a three-dimensional seven. So 2 years later, later, I decided to do it after all this stuff happened. And basically, what you're going to see that. Now, you're not going to see my process tonight. I'm going right to it. I'm going to go right to the meat of this whole thing. Tomorrow, I will show you the transformation that you can use, that I use to find this. I used an order. I used a law firm that I will share with you. Anybody can use. And anything, painting, poetry, whatever you're interested in, architecture, business. Okay, so the first thing I want to show you, or tell you, is that form follows function. So you take an umbrella, the umbrella has got a form that has a function. You can keep your drive. Also, you can close it up and put it into a line. So form plus function. The heart has a form, it has a function, based on the form. The doctors don't know the form. Of course, they know. They do CAT scans, they open the cadavers, and they see what the shape is and everything, but they don't know where it comes from. You don't know what's behind it, the geometry behind it. And, you know, of course, I didn't either. So I want you to know that, and also, if this could go on, how do you turn this up? I wanted to also show you that the Platonic forms, which are five of them, there are only five. And the five Platonic forms I have here on the screen, maybe, and they are based on the elements of water, air, and fire.
There they are.
Now these are the Platonic forms. Yeah? These are between 4,000 and 5,000 years old. They've been dug out of the earth in Ireland, and they are the five Platonic forms. And there are only five, and there aren't any others. And they have been studying these all the way through. Kepler, Da Vinci, all of them have been studying these forms. I did too. Because I thought that the seven would have some kind of relationship to the earth, and it would help me understand it. So that's one thing. Now, we have to start developing our imagination. Imaginations are images, the pictures. But the problem is with the imagination is because it can be, you can think of, oh, that's just an imagination. That's not the kind of imagination we're after. Imagination is fantasy. We can do anything we want with our imagination. We need to take our imaginations and make them lawful. So that when you see something that's not lawful, okay, we need to develop the capacity to be able to judge what we see and do and so forth. And I'm going to show you that in geometry. So one of the really cool things about geometry is so simple and so profound. And all I do is just draw on this board.